studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown. Good Lord, show me the way.
Just incredible hearing all of you already. It's hard not to start crying right away, that's my feeling, because some of you I worked with in different times. With Larry, I mean, we were partners in crime in Russia. Yeah. That's fairly recently, that's only 20 years ago, right? Yeah. Quite recently. How about Steve and Roseanne? That was about 35 years ago, right?
At least.
At least. I mean, it's just so incredible to see each other.
How did you keep so young?
And how did I keep so young? Well, that's very kind, you know. You never see me in the mirror early in the morning. Struggling to make it to the UK and all that. Our lives is just so incredible. We're brought together by true parents, right? And we're truly, their love is reverberating around the world in such an incredible way. And they're bringing all of us together. And just to see Deloise with her wonderful poor husband. I used to live with your wife, you know. You should be jealous. Old flame from the past. No, we were pioneers at San Francisco State University. We were CARP pioneers with Tiger Park, or even before Tiger Park joined CARP, actually. And I have so many memories from that time, such an incredible time, actually. We used to go up to the holy ground at Twin Peaks and stay all night sometimes, and just have incredible experiences with God. And Deloise was my older sister, and she taught me so much, actually. It's just amazing to see you. Anyway, and look at this guy, Drew, man, he's, you know. Anyway, it's just really good to see you, and even those of us who don't know each other, I'm sure we'll get to know each other well this weekend. And experience what God is all about as a family. Because to me, the divine principle is not a theory. And it's not just words, or and certainly not just a philosophy. But it's our life. It's our life as a family and as a community of brothers and sisters. Last weekend, I did a workshop, a healing personal development workshop. We were working with something called family constellations. It's a type of therapy for healing the family. And my wife and I work a lot with the emotion code. We work with Dr. Bradley Nelson, who's trained us up to do that work. And I do also body talk, which is another type of therapy. So that's what we do. And we work with the Blessed Family Department in Europe and in the UK. I also have a gardening business because I have a passion for gardening. I had been away from my home country for 20 years, and we went back really to take care of my parents, who were getting quite ill. So we left Russia in 1995, and we went back to England, and I became the gardener at St. Paul's Cathedral. Do you know where St. Paul's Cathedral is? In London. And I was the Bishop of London's gardener. He's the one that gave a sermon at the royal wedding the other day. Great friend of mine. And did you see the royal wedding, some of you?
No way.
No way. I was hoping somebody would say that. No way. You don't even know what cricket is here, do you? You have no idea. Even though there's, you know, about 800 million Indians that play cricket, you know. Anyway, I'm just kidding. But there was a moment in the ceremony when the bride and groom were at the front of the cathedral, they brought the garden into the cathedral. Those of you who saw it, it was quite amazing, actually. They brought all these trees in. So it was like a wedding in a garden, but inside the Westminster Abbey. And there was a moment when the dean of the abbey, right at the end of the ceremony, he wrapped a cloth around the bride and groom's hands. Some of you saw that, right? And he quoted one sentence from Jesus. And that was, "What God has joined, let no man separate or rent asunder." Right? And at that point, my wife and I were just weeping. You know? Because that is really divine principle, what divine principle is really about. Mm. It's about, you know, one man and one woman and starting a new life, you know, a new lineage and a new world. You know? So what God has joined, no man should rent asunder. Right? If we understand that, we actually understand what the principle is about. Right? It's so very precious. The equality of man and woman. You know, Osama bin Laden, he had 17 stepmothers, I think, and 51 siblings. Did you know that? I read a psychological profile of his once. I think it was probably quite messed up, his family, don't you think so? You know, so many times we take for granted what we have. Isn't it here? I work a lot in Africa. That's my other mission. I also do IRFF. And I work with two schools in Zambia and in Uganda. And I work with Africa Weight. You've probably heard of Weight from Washington, D.C., right? But it's really developing a lot in Africa these days. And we have about 2,000 Weight members in Uganda. And it's so that the kids at the high schools, they can really pick up the principle through weight. Because what is weight? Weight is the commandment, actually, right? It means, so all the kids in Uganda, they have a weight t-shirt, but they have to have fulfilled the Ten Commandments. There's 10 commandments in order to become a weight member, right? There's no snogging, no girlfriend, boyfriend, no drink, no drugs. Like this, you know, and healthy lifestyle, etc. Anyway, I won't bore you with all the details of the Ten Commandments. You probably know them already. You should be the ones teaching, actually, not me. But anyway, they have a t-shirt. On the front it says weight, and on the back it says, do you know what it says? Maybe some of you know. It says, "You're worth waiting for, and so am I." Yeah? You're worth waiting for, and so am I. I was reading some stuff with Mark Gunders the other day. He was talking about how people who have many relationships before they're married, it's like a little part of their heart is just given away each time they have a relationship. So like when a person has a sexual relationship, it's not just a physical thing, right? We know that. I'm sure you all know that as children of two parents. And there's an emotional connection is made. And a part of our heart is given to that person. And there are spiritual elements that are shared between those two people. And so the more people indulge in free sex, the more they destroy their ability to love their true lifetime partner. There's plenty of research about it. It's been proven, basically. Right? So God is working in so many ways to teach the principle to everybody. You know, the word I hate the most, so just to give you fair warning, right, is the word member. People in Germany, they use that word a lot. Who is a member and who is not a member? Wait a minute, what are we talking about members here? You know, you get confused. That's a joke.
Roseanne got it.
Roseanne got the joke. Anyway, you have to be very quick to get the strange British humour. Even though I am Californian, actually, I joined the church in California My spiritual father is Josh Carter, and I was living in Vancouver Island just before I joined. So I feel like coming here and meeting your community for the first time is like coming home for me. I actually lived in an Indian village in Vancouver Island near Tofinam. Some of you know where that is. And they taught me so much, those people, just before I joined our True Parents family. And they gave me a book, actually. It was called The Warriors of the Rainbow. I don't think it's even in print anymore. But in the book, I mean, God just prepared me so much, because this tribe, they had, through their spiritual communication, they knew that when Jesus came again, it wouldn't be the same Jesus. And they explained that John the Baptist was Elijah. You know, they explained all these things to me. And yet they were not belonging to any church or any particular faith, this tribe, but they knew all these things. And so who are the warriors of the rainbow? It's you, actually. The people of all faiths, all backgrounds, who would come when the Messiah comes again and break down all the walls, all the barriers, and become God's family. So let's not talk about members, but brothers and sisters. And realize that everyone in this whole world is my brother and sister. Even if they don't realize it yet. It just means they haven't figured it out yet. In an intellectual way, or they haven't had some kind of spiritual awakening, maybe quite yet, but they are already my brother and sister. We shouldn't have a concept that limits us. Otherwise, we can't really change this world. So once everybody is here tomorrow morning, we'll have a ceremony, right? It's called the water ceremony, and it's what True Father is doing on his world tour. Maybe you've seen it, some of you, on the internet. But before Father comes up to speak, there are certain religious leaders come from five or six different traditions, and they pour water from however many religions are represented, from cups into a bowl, right? And then we read. 2 days ago, on the 11th, Dr. Walsh read from Father's autobiography. Very simple passage about how each religion is like a stream, right, flowing into the great river and going towards the same destination. So Father's view is totally universal. He's not concerned about Unification Church or who's a member, who isn't a member. He's concerned about world peace, world unification. That's all he's concerned about. So that water ceremony is very profound, actually. It's showing that the Messiah comes for all people to be reunited. So the warriors of the rainbow, that's the meaning of people of all faiths and all colors who come together to create the family of God, to restore the family of God. And that's who you are. That's why looking out at your faces, for me, it's just so beautiful, actually, to see you. And I can imagine some of your stories are so difficult. I can imagine. Some of you have 7 children, 4 children, times it. But we should always be very sensitive, right, as blessed families. I know brothers and sisters who have no children, couldn't have children.